Welcome to Freshestner channel. Today's video is about IAF recruitment 2021. IAF has opened its vacancy for Group C civilian post. So we are going to know about all of the details regarding the eligibility, selection and also how to apply to this positions. All of this in this video, we are going to cover it up. Before that, if you want to read about the recruitment details on your own, you can check the link from the description box. Alternatively, you can also head over to Google and search for IAF Group C Recruitment 2021 Freshers Now. Our website will give you information, the links to directly apply and also the access to the official notification with one click. All of this can be accessed through Freshers Now website. Don't forget to check it out. Join us through Telegram and get regular job updates. The link to join directly is placed in the description box, so don't forget to check it out. Indian Air Force has opened its vacancy for Group C civilian post, as I've already mentioned. Now, Group C civilian has opened its locations across many places in India. So, as we can see in the first column right here, we can see the postal addresses, the post and the number of vacancies. These vacancies are further divided into category wise SC, ST, OBC, PWD. According to the categories that you're belonging to, you can see the number of vacancies which are opened up. Now, before we head in, please note that applications are invited for the eligible Indian citizens for Group C civilian post in various Air Force stations or units, and the eligibility criterias and the regarding post, all of those are mentioned in a tabular format here. So first off, we can see that the postal addresses are mentioned here. The postal addresses, and here is the post. The posts are as follows: Cook, MTS, Laundryman, CNS, MWS, KAC, Mechanic, Carpenter, MTS, again Carpenter, you have Painter, Carpenter, Fitter, LDC, Cook, etc. So all of those posts are available in various places in India. The addresses of the places are mentioned here. You have 1 to 5 vacancies in each of the posts. Now these vacancies number can differ, which means these vacancies can increase or decrease according to the requirement of the organization. And here is the PWD category candidates disability consideration. So blindness with low vision, blindness and low vision, deaf and hard of hearing, locomotor disability and autism, intellectual disability, etc. So all of this will be considered under PWD category. And next is the age limit. Whoever is in between 18 to 25 years of age, you are eligible to apply. Relaxations are as follows: 3 years is given for OBC, 5 years for SCST, PWD is given 10 years. Whoever has rendered their service for more than 6 months, they are considered under ex-servicemen. For them, according to the service, the relaxation will be applicable. On all of those who are departmental employees, 40 years for UR, 43 for OBC, 45 for SC or ST. The relaxation for the candidates will be applicable according to the Government of India rules. Heading over to the next section, which is the pay scale and the education requirement for the post. Now, pay scale is given according to the pay level wise and no such amount is mentioned. So, according to this level 7 CPC, the pay scale will be given to you. Education requirement for the post of a storekeeper is, for you should have an essential qualification, which is a graduate from a university or institute, and desirable is experience in handling stores and accounts in stores. And here, even in the education qualification, you have two divisions, which is essential qualification and desirable qualification. Essential in the sense you should have that, and desirable is the first preference will be given to all of those who have fulfilled the desirable qualifications. Heading over to the lower divisional clerk, which is you should have a 12th standard pass and a typing speed of 35 words per minute in English and 30 words per minute in Hindi. Next is the storekeeper post. You should have a 12th standard pass. Along with that, desirable would be experience in handling stores and keeping accounts in stores. For cook, it's a matriculation pass. For painter, it's 10th standard pass. Along with that, you should have an industrial training institute certificate of painter, and then carpenter, 10th standard pass and ITI certificate of trade of carpenter. Next is the same for coppersmith, 10 standard pass, and then you should have a relevant trade certificate. Heading over for the next post, most of the post is having the essential qualifications which you should be fulfilling, it which is a matriculation pass or a 12 standard pass. And desirable would be if you are having a 1 year of experience in the relevant trade respectively. Next section is the mode of selection as to how the officials are going to select the candidates. This section will give you all of the details regarding the selection procedure. The mode of selection is as follows. Firstly, the candidate will be scrutinized according to the age limit, the education qualifications, their experience, and all of the documents which are being provided from the candidate. So accordingly, a shortlisting will be made. Further, all of those who have been shortlisted or eligible in regards to all of the documents which they have provided, if they have fulfilled the criteria, then they will be sent the call letters. The call letters will be for the written test. All of the eligible candidates hereby have to attend the written test. The written test will be basing on the minimum education qualification itself, and here they have given the syllabus which you should prepare for the written examination. Now this syllabus is again divided into post wise. So whichever post that you are applying to, you can relate to that syllabus, note it down, and you can start your preparation. For LDC, it's general intelligence, English language, numerical ability, and general awareness. And for stenographers is general intelligence, reasoning, general awareness, English language, and comprehension. Here for MTS, HKS, IA Word, SAHAK, Laundryman, Messed Up, and Vulcanizer is general intelligence, reasoning, aptitude, English, and general awareness. For all of the trade posts, the same. General intelligence and reasoning, numerical aptitude, English awareness, and trade post related questions will be asked. Now these questions will be in English and Hindi as well. And next, whoever has passed this written examination, and written examination consideration is going to be for 100% weightage. After the written examination, shortlisting will be made, and all of those candidates will be further called for skill test, physical test, or the practical test as they have mentioned. So in this physical test or skill test, whichever they are going to be conducted in the later part of the stage, this is just a qualifying test and nothing percentage wise. So after that, document verification will be made during that test itself. So when you have been shortlisted in the merit list, all of those candidates should take your original documents for the skill test or the practical test, whichever will be conducting after the written test, whoever has been qualified in the written test. Now the last date which you have to remember for sending your application is 30 days from the issue of the notification. So priorly you have to make your own arrangements of keeping all your documents ready and along with the application form. You can access the application form in the same notification itself. When you come down, you can see the pro forma of the application form, and then you can print it out and you can start applying. Next, we will see as to how to apply and how you can access the application form. Same official notification link will be in the description box. You can check it out, and with one click you can open the same notification and access the application form. So after you access the application form, you how to apply, what is the application procedure. Now whoever is eligible, if you think you have fulfilled the criteria of whatever they have mentioned here, if you are willing to apply, then print in your application form. Type it in Hindi or in English. Along with your application form, attach all of the relevant documents, whether it's education, caste, experience, qualifications, all of those documents you have to attach it, and you have to send it to the organization through an ordinary post. Now please keep in mind that registered post, speed post, courier, all of this will not be accepted, and the application also will not be considered. So please make note that you have to send in your application form along with the relevant documents in an envelope through an ordinary post itself. How you have to send it? All the documents of the education qualifications, age, qualifications, physically handicapped, experience, caste certificates, all of those which are mentioned here, it should be self-attested, and you have to attach that to the application form. And whoever is belonging to the SCST OBC, you have to attach all the relevant certificates if you want the age relaxations also. And then same applies for the ex-servicemen also. You have to attach the photocopy of the discharge book along with your application form, and you have to type it in Hindi or in English. You have to attach your recent passport photograph also, and then you have to send it to the organization. And before you send it, make sure on your envelope you put a 10 rupees stamp, paste it on it, and then clearly write application for the post of and the category and also the advertisement number. Clearly mention it in the bold letters on your application form so that it would be very clear for the person to read and also understand to which post you are applying to. And you should also put 2 passport size photographs in the application form as well. Next section is the general instruction. This is for all the candidates who are processing through this particular organization to remember general terms and conditions from the organization. You have to make sure you are sending your applications before the last date. As it is an ordinary post, make sure you are starting your application process earlier. You should fulfill the minimum qualifications. And next, the Center for Examinations for written, skill test, practical test, all of this will be intimated to the candidates priorly after dates, and then no allowances will be given in order to attend the tests. Selected candidates will be subjected to serve the Indian service liability, and then you have to fulfill the selection criteria, and only after the written test being qualified you will be called for the practical test or the skill test, also document verification. And you have to bring only original documents when you have been attending the practical test or the skill test. Then there will be simultaneously the test which will be conducted for all of the categories, and the responsibility of the category for the candidate, whoever is applying for more than one test, whoever, if you have applied for more than one post, make note that all the categories will be conducted in the same date, it will not be clashing. And next, you have to importantly note down the COVID-19 instructions, follow the guidelines according to the government, and also the precautions in this COVID issue. Next is, as I've mentioned earlier, the pro forma for the application form is mentioned here. So you can see the application form is clearly mentioned. You can print it out and then you can start typing it in. You can also type it in Hindi or in English, print it out, and then attach all the documents, put it in an envelope, and along with the 10 rupees stamp, stick it on the envelope and write which post you are applying to, category, and also along with that you should write the advertisement number as well. Send it before the last date to the officials. The access for the official notification will be in the description box. Don't forget to check it out. And if you have further queries, please place them in the comment section. Don't forget to subscribe, and thank you for watching.